Hello my friends, I'm your host Rishabh Rajesh. If you like our channel, please subscribe to our channel and after subscribing, press the bell icon to stay notified for latest updates. Hello friends and welcome back to the channel. I'm Rishabh from AutoDNA and in this video we are going to review the limousine variant of the all new Kia Carnival. So these are the headlights of the car with dual projectors with LED along with side turn indicators, and here we have the fog lamp, which is an ice cube fog lamp along with chrome surrounds. We have a standard really wide and really thick looking Tiger grille with chrome inserts, and on the top we have the Kia branding in chrome or emblazoned in chrome. The front looks very stylish and very appealing and very fruitful to the eye. We get chunky 18-inch sputtering alloy wheels over here, which kind of remind me of chrome alloys. Here we have the sidestep with the Carnival branding, and this sidestep is quite wide as the car itself has a really wide and a whooping wheelbase. Then this is the part where the sliding door electronically goes back. So now we'll show you how it is done. Let's press it once and bingo, it opens up on its own, and I love the way it does. It's a very satisfying feeling to it. And this is a normal door which can be opened, and this is the driver's side's door, and in the foreign market it is known as the Sedona or Grand Carnival, but the Grand Carnival is bigger than this. It's in 11 seater configuration, which is the maximum. Here in India it is the 9 seater configuration, which is the most. Now let's show you with the key we can close and open the rear doors. So now we'll show you. If you press the right second row right button, automatically the door will pop close. I mean it will close. So yeah, that's the way it does. So it's a really clean and a crisp mechanism which is followed, and these doors don't close with the key. This are to be manually closed. There's a chrome embossed auto badging. The ORVM is with a side turn indicator, which looks really good and looks quite chic and sweet. The rear profile again is very high and has a good amount of height. And overall, let's show you the tail lamp of this car. So this has LED tail lamps, and it has kind of a boomerang shaped design or a pin design where one end is connected to the other and then they go the separate way. There's a Kia branding in chrome. There's a rear whitewash function defoggers and a rear body colored spoiler along with high mount stop lamp. There's a limousine badging. Then from the main plating of chrome, there's another chrome which extends, and there's a Carnival badging as well. The interior we'll talk about, and here we can see we get a steering wheel which is a bit dated. I would not say a lot, but it looks a bit dated and looks a bit old fashioned, but still it's not really focused on the customer driving it. It's more of a chauffeur driven car. There's an analog instrument cluster. Then there's kind of a brownish luxury finishing. There's soft touch material. There's leather finishing over here. Even the armrest on the door is completed in leather. There's again the same brown luxurious finishing along with all the buttons. And here we have enough space for magazine holders, for 1 liter bottle storage. And here we have the side step, which is strong enough to withstand a maximum weight of at least 100 to 180 kgs of weight. We get dual tone leather seats and black and beige, and we get driver ventilated seats. And now let's go to the center console. So on the center console you get a 8-inch HD AVN with UO Connect system only on the top and limousine variant. We get a tri-zone climate control, and again the same brown finishing is finished on the dashboard. The whole dashboard is, the upper part is in soft touch material and the lower part in plastic. And there are two glove box. There's a ventilated seat option, auto hold, auto assist, and there's an 8-speed Sportsmatic transmission. There's a big armrest along with a lot of switches to keep your tablet, to keep your iPad, or to keep anything which you want. Then let's see what else we have over here. And as I told you, the analog instrument cluster, which is very plain and simple. From here we can control the sunroof, and from here also we can open the doors, and when we clicked it, it opens. Now we'll show you from the other side so you might get a better view of it. So now let's press the other side of it, and bingo, it opens up on its own, and I love the way it does. There are cabin reading lights as well, and here's a sunroof. There are dual sunroof in this car, and now it will not open. There's a kind of a rear mirror kind of a thing through which you can see what is going on at the back of the car. And overall, I like the way the interior is designed. So these are the VIP seats of the car in the second row, and this is the main place. All are hand control. There are no buttons like we get on many other cars. There's a full leg rest which looks premium, but we'll show you again how it works, how it is done, and much more. So in 3, 2, and 1, we'll see the VIP seats of this car. Let's open the door again with the key, and yeah, it's magic. And now let's show you the way it is done. So there's a armrest over here as well, and along with, you get leg rest as well, which looks very premium. So all the controls are there, which is manually operated. Then you can also shift the seats left and right so that it will be easy for the third row passengers to ingress and egress. And as well as it's quite comfy, and it looks very supportive. And when I sat on it, it looks and feels very premium, supportive, and wonderful. So here we can see we get a AC 220 volt computer charging socket over here. And this is mainly for your phone so that you can charge it on the go. There's a fast charging USB port. There are two cup holders. There's a smart air purifier. There's an AC control over there. Then there is AC vent here. Then there's a 10.1 inch touchscreen infotainment system on the back for you, or rear seat entertainment we can say, which keeps you entertained on the go. And these are independent screens, which means like the accessory which you get, the same thing which one person watches, you also have to watch the same. But in this, people can watch the independent shows, or they can listen to independent music without having the hassle of looking at the same thing which you want. There are rear sun shades as well, or rear sun blinds, and they are adjusted with a hook. There's a lot of leg space over here. Then there's a magazine holder over here. Then, as I told you, again a magazine holder with a brochure fit here. And I'm quite luxurious, I'm quite comfortable out here, and I feel quite safe, comfy, and I have the feeling of a CEO inside this car. Then, as I told you, there's another sunroof over here, and I'm sorry for the shake. And again, it opens up to a bright and serene environment, just like this. If you go on long drives like Ooty or somewhere, where you will get wonderful scenic views on the go. And here you can enjoy the daily sunlight out here. And here's the third row of seats, which is again very spacious and very comfortable. I just now sat in it. The limousine variant of the Kia Carnival is priced at 41 lakh rupees, and it's quite a competitive pricing, and according to the Wellfire, it's much value for money and offers many features which the Wellfire also doesn't offer. So now the Wellfire is also going to launch in India. See you soon. So friends, thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then do give this video a like. Also subscribe to our channel, and after subscribing, press the bell icon to stay notified for latest updates. Also, as I told you, press the bell icon and also comment down below. Thank you.